Thank you. It's Subscriber Sunday. Yeah, I too am going bananas, Poobles. I just hope you don't split. You'd be cocoa nuts to miss this stream. Does that work? Yeah, I'm just looking, because obviously apes don't have tails, monkeys do have tails. They don't have tails, but they look little like monkeys, but they are, in fact, apes. So it's all good. I'm a little bit sick today, so there might be a lot of muted coughing. But other than that, I feel good. How are you guys doing? I hope you've had a good weekend. I did that thing of unlocking developer mode on my Xbox. And let me tell you, those GameCube games... they look mighty fine. Not today. Ginger, I don't think it's not that kind of sickness. And it's certainly not contagious through Twitch. I don't think. Well, yeah, I don't know what kind of sickness it is then if I have evil breath. Is there God. Is there good money in vomit content? So hello Adam. What a great first sentence to type in chat. Hey, he's gonna puke. I'm not going to. Not today, anyway. We'll save that for another... We'll save that for, like, a follow goal or something. Oh, man. Ugh. Ugh, mukbang is... gross. But don't worry about those, because today is Subscriber Sunday, where we play a game picked by a subscriber on a Sunday. And today it's Ape Escape, picked by Chris, the legendary Chris. Not me, again, I'm not talking in third person. The other Chris, who made the overlays for me. He's a great guy and thorough. And today we're playing Ape Escape in his honor. You know what? Good for them! They're still going, they're still making content. Because, you know, they've been around ages now. That's longevity. Longevity. There we go. That's what that is. I'm going to have to add that very, very expensive channel point redeem in, Chris, but it's not live today, and I'm not going to be sick, everybody. But thank you for your concern. And I've never seen concern in that sort of form before. Oh, let's watch him until he's sick. Anyway, it's Subscriber Sunday. I can see that, Chris, because you've sat through some of my content. Ooh. How's the recovery going? Is the recovery bar up to the old hundo yet? I hope you're feeling great. And I'm feeling great to have you guys here for Subscriber Sunday. See, I know there's been a bit of hoo-ha around these classic PlayStation versions on the current PlayStation Plus service. Games like Ape Escape are the PAL ROMs, the 50Hz PAL ROMs, and they've sort of done a kind of frame correction thing to make it look like it's not a PAL ROM, but apparently doesn't look that great. However, like I said, I do believe there are trophies. There are trophies for some of these old games, so that's really cool. And all I know for sure is that we need the DualShock, the dual analog PlayStation controller, and I think I see two sticks on this controller, so I think we're good to go. So let's go! Hunt down hundreds of cheeky chimps in the original Ape Escape TM. Alright, I will. Oh! It's been updated, everybody, again. Interesting. Hopefully this means it won't look strange. I could run this on another console, like I said, but... trophies, that's tantalizing, isn't it? I think so, anyway. Yeah. How's it going, Andy? It's great to see you. Welcome to Subscriber Sunday. Exactly. You know, you must know a few Andrew apes out there. There it is. Oh yeah, probably 4x3 for this, isn't it? Anyway, those GameCube games running on Dolphin on this Series X. It just looks incredible. You can install like the HD texture packs as well. I can't even. Here we go. So what's the story here then? This guy, Caesar, the first ape who ever put on a helmet with a light on it and said no. Well, hold on, Ginger. So you're not an ape anymore and you're not called Miles anymore. Are you one of these out of control apes? Should we, Again, this is Chris's handiwork here. This is your handiwork, Chris. So thank you again for that. Thanks again for the subs. Apes have gone nuts. We have to catch them. Essentially, that's what's going on here. You can also run Duck Station on the Series X in developer mode. Duck Station, of course, PlayStation emulator. I had a little dip into it. I didn't see how you could up-res the games, but who knows where the possibilities lie with that, because I've run Duck Station on the PC before and you can make it like 4K with a click of a button. But we won't be doing that today, because those textures, they could have been done a bit more work with those TD. Anyway, let's go. Let's catch some bloody apes. Yeah, not played this game before. I was playing on the N64 at the time. But you know, fast forward to the launch of PlayStation All-Stars Battle Royale, and Ape Escape Man was one of the characters. So I can't leave such a principal PlayStation franchise unplayed. So thank you, Chris, for helping me get there. The polygons look nice and cleaned up, though, don't they?
Spike, do you think the professor finished his time machine?
He said he's almost done.
Set in England?
Then maybe we can ride it today.
If so, I'm riding on it first.
Hey, that isn't fair, Spike. Hey, wait up.
Well, surely the first one there gets it, so you better speed up, old blue hair. Well, these young children out there hanging out with these professors and doctors, you know.
No, run, you two.
What accent did you keep in your memories, Chris? Russian? Oh no, disaster. You damn apes! Damn dirty apes! Nice. Very much the Minions before the Minions. Yeah, of course you would, wouldn't you? Except you have played this game, so I don't know why you did that. You know I'm not American, don't you? America is not the world, Chris.
Okay, I got it. This becomes this, and when it becomes that, this goes like this. Therefore, that became this.
Uh-huh.
We did it, Katie. The time machine is completed.
This isn't the time for that.
Exactly, Adam. And that's Ape Escape, everyone. There's a professor. I like his moustache talking animation. That was pretty cool.
Spike, can you hear me?
Yes.
Something awful has happened. You have slipped in time with the accident earlier. You will soon arrive in the prehistoric era when dinosaurs existed.
Oh no, time travel as well as escaped apes.
In time in various eras.
This is a lot on my plate for a Sunday. Traditionally, the day of rest.
So, Spike, I need you to do this for me.
I'm going to do it.
You should have two of my gadget inventions. I want you to use these to catch as many monkeys as you can.
Well, are they apes or are they monkeys?
Using the net. And if by any chance you are in danger...
I thought they'd taken such care to get it right. But he's already called them monkeys. And this guy's supposed to be a man of science.
It's a tough job, but you can do it. I'm relying on you.
It's always down to me, isn't it? every little job, from saving the world to catching every single monkey slash ape. They're calling them monkeys now. I don't. Can't someone else do it? Seriously though, can't someone? Okay, here we go.
Let's go.
All right, so. Yeah, I was doing it already. Beat the enemies by swinging and turning the stun club around. Turning. You can also make the monkeys fall down. That's just a separate sentence. I can also just make the monkeys fall down with my odor. What? How? What? Oh, I didn't read that. Oh, man. Oh, that's cool, because I didn't read that second bit. Swing the stun club with the right stick. I know that bit already. What? Whoa, what's going on with these tutorials? Press the R button to jump at the start. And also, don't forget, jump with the R button. Oh, bollocks. Okay. All right, come at you. Okay, controls are going to take a little bit of getting used to. I haven't played anything that attacks with the right analog stick in a little while. Ha! Yes! Ha ha! See? Trophies! See? I do keep wanting to adjust the camera with the right stick, but that's not gonna... Okay, there we go. I mean, frame rate-wise, I can't tell with the naked eye what's going on with the frame rate if this is now the NTSC ROM. It does look a bit jerky, but I can't tell if that's just the kind of texture warping, which is, of course, very common for a Sony PlayStation 1. What was that? Like a cookie? Like a biscuit? A really dry biscuit? Or a crumpet? Or an English muffin? What is that? Oh, it's gone now. But Ape Escape Experts. What am I collecting there? Come here, you. Yes. No net. I'm laughing at the all caps. Okay, Chris, it's a hobnob. But it wasn't a chocolate hobnob, so... I don't know. I mean, I'm obviously never going to say no to a plain hobnob, but I don't know, it has been a while. Just put chocolate on all of them. You know, digestives, hobnobs, and malted milks. My dad's favourite biscuit. And again, the dry ones, the plain ones, fine. You're going to need a tea or coffee, though, like a plain digestive, a rich tea or whatever. But those chocolate ones. Oh my god. Yeah, I know that. Wow, it's not just a net, it's a time net, everybody. Right, is this possible? Do I have a sprint? No, I have a crouch. I'm not making that. Oh, Chris, I love your enthusiasm. Right. How do I get up to them trees? Right. Do I have to bash him first? Oh, bro. My hobnob health has gone down one biscuit. So you don't need to beat them with your lightsaber, but you can if you want to. That's the Ape Escapers code that we live by. I'd go for a chocolate hobnob right now. That's some excellent typing.
She's You're good.
Mainly hitting that giant space bar, but still great typing. Don't Peter hate everything? They hate, like, genuinely have campaigned about, like, hunting animals in, like, Assassin's Creed and stuff. You know, the pretend video game virtual world animals in Assassin's Creed. Right. Step onto this switch to save the game. Okay, we should definitely do that. Don't want to lose that progress. Cool. Yeah, and that's my favorite game. ABS, like... You'll have to pry my ABS out of my ear. Cold dead hands, Peter. That is your real name. Yeah, let's save. Sure, yeah, save. Go for it. Yeah, and none of my PlayStation mates had this game back in the day either. I was playing stuff like Tekken, the first Tomb Raider, Battle Arena to Shinden, Crash Bandicoot. On my friend's PlayStations, but never Ape Escape. But it is already quite enjoyable, I have to say. Yes, they did! And that's worse, isn't it? Because that's taking a fictional video game that already exists and making it more gory. You know, what's the US Senate gonna think about that? Takes us back to the days of Night Trap. You know, the game that taught us to maim and mutilate women. Okay, okay. There's a lot of stuff to do in here. Alright, let's jump on this switch that he told me to. Oh, I've got a double jump, that's quite handy. Oh, another game I want to try is Jumping Flash. Another PlayStation platformer that I never played, always missed out on. And now again it's on here and, you know, the PlayStation Classic and everything. Hey, Sonny, how's it going, man? I probably had a bit too much Goldeneye on this channel lately. I do apologise about that. But Sonny, you know, whenever you're ready to go, zap! Yeah, Peter and Nuts, aren't they? Good in principle. But they just seem to be run by a bunch of lunatics. Again, their heart's in the right place. Probably. Right, let's go to the Raining Lake in the prehistoric era. Don't touch anything or we could completely alter the course of time.
This is a water net that shoots a net underwater.
Oh, my God, you played the game Jumping Flash and you got the movie Vertigo for free. The glory days of PlayStation that I missed out on, Chris. The next stage. Well, what's the RE4 release date, Sonny? Because we will be on that day one right here. Oh, can I wait? So many remakes. And then Tears of the Kingdom. The water net appears when you are in the water. That's handy. Swim around using the left stick. Okay, I will. Alright. Oh, and when's Kingdom? When's Tears of the Kingdom? Is that like a similar date? What a double release that's going to be to play at the same time. Resident Evil 4. Ah, okay. Yeah, that's a perfect release schedule, to be honest. The month of April, the best month, obviously, with my birthday in it. Lots of time to savour Resident Evil 4 Remake, and then Tears of the Kingdom in May. Yeah. It's going to be great. I think the only time I played Jumping Flash in... one of the stories you never told me about, Andy, on the bus. But yeah, it's just a game I never heard about back in the day, ever. But I really like the look of it, even now. Gonna say it didn't tell me how to get out. The sign on the left shows you how. Yeah, I know. Okay, cool. There we go. This must have been Whoa, okay. Hold on. Right. This must have been quite advanced for his time. I mean, you know, the right stick doesn't control the camera, but apart from that, you know, you're pressing in the stick for the first time. That was definitely something that took a lot while to get used to from being like an N64, Dreamcast, GameCube guy, because you weren't pushing in those sticks. And sometimes I still find it a little bit awkward to press the analog sticks in. Anyone else have that problem? For sprinting, sometimes it can be a little bit fiddly. I don't know. Well, I mean, that's something that parents at the time would probably be fuming about, isn't it? My son's come to me after I bought him a, you know, £200 PlayStation, and now he needs a new £50 controller. Pretty cool. But you know, parents were annoyed back in the day when Nintendo announced the Super Nintendo. His parents were like, well, he's already got Nintendo. So you don't understand, man, it's a new 16-bit Nintendo graphics. Parents just don't understand. Girls ain't nothing but trouble. Haha! Get wet! Silver! Nice! Exclamation mark, nice. Some of those early Metal Gear Solid games were painful to aim in during the saga that has been Monday Gear Solid, for sure, Chris. But I'm looking forward to seeing what Twin Snakes looks like in Dolphin on the Xbox, because yeah, I've never messed around with Dolphin before, ever. Never had the need to, but now it's really... Now we can like upscale things to 4K and it looks amazing. I don't know. Is there a platinum? Yes, there is. Look at that. No ape can escape brackets or monkeys. So get items, catch a certain amount of monkeys slash apes, do the mini games. Hey, I could definitely see myself maybe polishing this off on a Sunday. Just a nice relaxing old school game. The controls are, again, a bit confusing. R1 jump. Come here, you. What are the blue lights compared with the red and yellow lights on the top of their head? Yes! Got him! I got a PlayStation Plus. I can't remember what they're called. The one that's not premium. I tried the premium one for like a month because the upgrade pack was like £1 for like the rest of the month or whatever. And the top tier is just awful, isn't it? The selection is just pretty bad. And the coup de grace they're offering you on their top tier is cloud streaming. Don't get it. Oh yeah, I forgot about my double jump. Thanks, Professor. Ooh, gold jiggies. Oh no, I don't like the looks of him. He's not an ape. What are you doing in my game, sir? Ooh. Aha. Yeah, and he's giving out biscuits as well. Right, how do I see how many apes are there in the level? There we go. 3 apes left to get. Oh! These damn crocodile heads. Okay. Yeah. I definitely would have fired this game up by this point on this service, but I think, Chris, you mentioned it a little while ago that you'd like to see a bit of Ape Escape, so here it is. Don't forget, everybody, if you're a subscriber to this here channel and you want to see me check out a game, let me know and we'll check it out if I can. Come here, you!
Oh,
Oh no!
Instant drowning, is it? Blue is docile, or docile, or docile. Yellow is warning, red is alerted. Okay. Thank you. I appreciate that. Yeah, that double jump's gonna make things a lot easier. Okay, where's that other guy? There he is. If only I had like a sniper rifle net launcher. You know? I can just get them all from the start of the level. Ah, shit. I was gonna try and be stealthy, but. Cool. And you shouldn't feel guilty because these are evil apes. These are time traveling, mischievous apes. They could sort of destroy the whole space time continuum, so we can't let them sort of just get away with it. Get on the log, sir. Alright, let's see what's going on the other side. Aha! Excellent. Sway told me there was a quicker way to resurface, but can't remember what it is, because I thought it was right analog sticking, but that's launch water ape net, which of course we all know. We all knew that. Monday Gear Solid is back tomorrow, everybody. Yakuza is debuting on Tuesday, and we will be playing Yakuza 0 after much back and forth. And I was going to be doing a Wednesday with Kai, but I am getting a tooth taken out on Wednesday, and I'm probably not going to be in a streaming state in the evening, but we'll see. And that's all I got for you at the moment. But yes, I need more Subscriber Sunday suggestions from you guys. There's still some on the list, but I want more on the list. Okay. It's pretty generous, the hitbox of the kind of lightsaber thing. Making it quite accessible, enjoyable. Ape catching romp. What year was this? Because I'm wondering. This obviously Loch Ness Monster, of course, is reminding me of Mario 64. I'm just wondering how much later. This is obviously post Mario 64. And I wonder by how much. Stop at you. Yes. Okay, do I have a time? Is there a timer going and when I get punished for waiting ages for this Loch Ness Monster? So anyway, this, I'm out catching apes, right? And I'm trying to cross to the other side of this this little river. And this friendly gentleman shows up and he says, "I'll take you across the thing." And I said, "Oh, cool, that's really sweet of you." And I said, "How much do you charge?" He said, "Well, I need about 350. Well, it's about this time I noticed this nice gentleman was a Loch Ness Monster. Where is this taking me? What is this? This is pointless now. Right, what's in the mailbox? Yeah, I know. But you're just making me picture a chimp on skates, a grey fox, and that sounds awesome to me. So no, maybe I want to be a chimp skate. How you doing? It's great to see you. Cheers. Welcome to Subscriber Sunday, a nice laid back ape catching Subscriber Sunday, chosen by Chris. Again, not me, he's down in the chat right now. Or there. Oh, this is very sweet of you to ask. I'm having a good weekend, and it's great to see you. It's an even better weekend now, and I hope you've had a great weekend as well. A grey weekend, great fox. Okay.
Yeah.
I'm a little disappointed by this island. Oh, hello. Hello! Ha ha ha! Oh no, I just did Seth Rollins' laugh, and I hate that laugh. Ha ha ha! Yeah, I forgot the jump on again, didn't I? Come on now. Nice! Wait a minute. How many monkeys are left? I thought it was... Now that's a great laugh. Although not a great guy apparently, but again, he is a wrestler, so we just take that as assumed at this point. But yeah, Seth Rollins, a current wrestler, Grey Fox. I nearly said hip to the current wrestling product. Thank God I didn't say that. How many of you groovy cats are hip to the current wrestling product? I can't do Ted DiBiase's laugh. It's too good. But yeah, Seth Rollins. Yeah, it better not be. We don't have a launch date for it yet, though, do we? And I'm worried's not the right word, but I'm a no mercy guy, and even though there's a few No Mercy staff on the AEW game, like the director. It is being developed by Yuke's, and I know Yuke's are very popular with some wrestling game fans, but not so much with me. I hope it's good. My expectations were high, now they're kind of middle. But again, streaming that day one, obviously. Hopefully it's good. I really hope it's good. Modern wrestling game to be excited about is truly a rare sight these days. Dinosaur Valley. Is that where Star Fox Adventures takes place? Put that on the Dolphin emulator on the Series X. I don't know why I keep looking over there. The PS5's over there today. I'm streaming this off PS5. Series X is downstairs. I should be like that. Series X isn't over there. It's down there. In hell! Hey! I'm disappointed by them switching to monkeys mid-game. They lure you in with them like, oh, they've got their ape lore correct. And then bam, ha! Surprise, we're calling them monkeys. It's like, no! Oh, what's going on here? Is this a boss?
Let's go!
I mean, if I was a PlayStation owner, and I was playing this instead of, I was going to say like Banjo-Kazooie, but I didn't play Banjo-Kazooie back in the day. And ever since I've tried to go back and play it now, I don't know. Even though it's rare during the time when I love them the most, yeah, I don't know. Like, I can't really comment because I've not played a lot of it, but it just feels like, it always felt like a poor man's Mario 64. And now, the aesthetic's kind of hard to get past, which I don't understand, because I'm still up for sort of like cute stuff, you know, like I'll enjoy like the sweet nature of a Disney Pixar animated movie or whatever, but Banjo-Kazooie, also the soundtrack I've got a problem with, because it's rare during their heyday when they're pumping out amazing soundtrack after amazing soundtrack. And the Banjo-Kazooie theme is based around meh, 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 meh. And I'm like, no. What am I doing here? Apes Odyssey.
Yeah.
That door is blocking the way. How does it open? Well, there's a red switch right there. Can I do anything about it yet? Go back. I didn't even mean to go in there anyway.
Yeah.
Maybe that is the way. Let's go get some. Go get some apes. Damn, they're fast. Cool. Where's he gone? Oh no! How far away can they run? Come back here, you. You know, I bet monkeys are really sick of the banana stereotype. They're like, guys, we don't only eat bananas. That would be insane. That would be ludicrous. A diet of pure banana. Can you imagine? Ah, nice work, Grey Fox, because I bet that wasn't easy either. Devil May Cry, another series I need to give more time to. However, you've got to be quite good at video games to get like decent rankings in that, don't you? And I don't know if I'm that guy. And you know, I should have been the one to fill your dark soul with light. Oh, wait a minute, I don't catch that. That's true. It just comes down to that, doesn't it? Yeah, you know, stop that. Literally just, you know, picked up a Devil May Cry game here and there for a couple of minutes. But yeah, I 100%ed Ragnarok and I really, really miss it already. But the good news is I've got all that stuff to go back to in God of War 2018. But it really, you know, after, I mean, Ragnarok is so stunning. It really is. And it's a little bit of a shame that now I'm doing all this stuff, but I don't have the lush worlds of Ragnarok to be like, oh, wow. And, you know, I don't know, though. It's just cool. It's more, you know, more God of War content. But, yeah, you know, like, Ragnarok 2 now. Oh, thank you, Sony Santa Monica. That was great. Now make another one. I'm not sure about this music. Ah, oh, nice. King of Fighters. What am I doing here? Oh, shit! Nice. Listen, Birdo, you're confused. This ape has tricked you. It is not one of your offspring. Ash, it's going great. We're catching monkeys slash apes. Oh no, we've been caught. How ironic. How's your owl friend? Ash, for you guys, for you foxhounds who don't know, Ash lives in Australia and only gets visits from the most unbelievably gorgeous owl I've ever seen in my life. My God, I can't even believe it. I've got a couple of foxes in my area. I'm not talking about my family members. But no owls. Just incredible. I think you might have to start your own sort of nature documentary, Ash. You can just film it from your window as well. Alright, what's going on in here? Oh no! It's a bloody T-Rex. T-Rex is very aggressive and won't be hurt by your weapons. I just want the monkey off its back. Hit the T-Rex and run to the rocks. When the T-Rex runs after you, jump out of the way. If he hits his head... Okay. Gotta get him to drop the monkey. Drop the monkey! Drop the monkey! It's not an owl? It's definitely an owl. No, I know nothing about ornithology. This monkey's just sitting here. You don't even have to fight a T-Rex to get that guy. No, that even monkey's not here today, Grey Fox. Don't scare me like that. So what is it then? If it's not an owl, what is it? Oh, What is this lineup for a festival this summer? Oh, okay, I think they were joking. McFly are playing, though. At Pub in the Park in Tunbridge Wells. Sister Sledge and Fleetwood Mac apparently as well. Didn't say that they're tribute acts, so they obviously won't be if I spend my money on a ticket to Pub in the Park in Tunbridge Wells. Okay. Well, that's kind of what I wanted. It did hit its head on a rock, however, I was very much still in the line of danger. Right. Oh shit! Well, he handles lava a lot better than Mario does, doesn't he? And I'm nervous about the Mario movie again. That clip, he was too Seth Rogen and not enough Donkey Kong. I mean, right? Am I right? Just me? And I don't even hate Seth Rogen, but I don't want... Must Donkey Kong be Seth Rogen now? Is that fair? What did Donkey Kong ever do to deserve that? Drop that monkey! Hey! Hey! What the hell? Sweet skid T-Rex, but it's not what we're after. Yeah, go on, run! Yes! You stupid monkey! You're stupid now! Yeah. Well, hey, now my friend Mike, who you may know from Wednesdays, he sent it to our WhatsApp group and he said this is still really funny or something. So I thought it was an old thing that I might have already seen. But is it something new?
You're good.
I think the answer is no. But I'm not sure. I might have seen it. Okay, we should probably save it. Andrew, you were one of my PlayStation friends. Why didn't you educate me on Jumping Flash and Ape Escape back in the day? Why did you allow me to force you to put on Tomb Raider 2 for like 3 straight hours until you had to say, Chris, can we please play something else? But I didn't have Tomb Raider 2 at the time. Right. Unbelievable, Andrew. Unbelievable. Cool. Alright. No, that was also Enter. Back in the day when they were appeasing both the East and the West. Can I just return? Oh, God. Oh, whatever. No! Return! Okay, there we go. So have we done the dinosaur land yet? What time period are we going through now? Can I get some story, please? We need some story updates. What is this? Settings? No, it's the shop, is it? As long as the shame is felt, then I'm fine. I'm fine with it. Alright. Back over here, I guess. Nice, nice, nice. I'll tell you what, the way that Dolphin emulator makes Mario Galaxy 2 look that Nintendo didn't thought deserved to go on the 3D All-Stars collection. It's just amazing. I need to assign a button to shake the Wiimote, because Mario Galaxy 2, you've got an attack. You shake the Wiimote and you spin, but my god, I don't know. Even the games that you don't have HD texture packs for, they look amazing. We're still kind of in the olden times here with the Cenozoic era. Jungle River.
Spike!
Yes.
A new gadget is completed.
Cool, what is it?
This is a monkey radar that will help you in finding monkeys.
What about apes?
I will send these over. Try them out in your training space. If you don't clear the training, you cannot advance to the next stage. Well, good luck.
No, I do not promise to do my best. I'm just thinking of an idea here. No adverts for Ape Escape 1 made back in the day. No wonder I didn't know about it. There's trailers for the sequels, but if you haven't played the first one, how are you going to know what's going on? Oh, no, I found it. I was going to say, I seem to remember... seeing... Right, anyway. Use the radar to find the monkeys hiding in the box. Okay. Okay. Don't open a box without a monkey, or you have to start over. Okay. Well, I have a feeling like there'll be a monkey in here. Yeah. Ah, it's not a monkey. These stupid training monkeys. Yeah, and this one. I even put them all next to each other. I saw the monkeys. To use the monkey radar, press the start button, and then the try. Okay. I'm already using the monkey radar. Hey! These silver trophies are coming thick and fast, and I love it.
We're going to enter a period called the Cenozoic Era. It is a period after the dinosaurs became extinct. There shouldn't be any human life, but I've somehow confirmed evidences of civilization. This isn't a work of the monkeys. It will be a great discovery for science. I'd really like to investigate this matter, but we must first find the monkeys. Oh yes, you may have already noticed, but it's easier to catch the monkeys if you approach them without being noticed by laying low or hiding. Basically, you won't be noticed as much if you lay low rather than standing still without moving. I hope this helps. Well, I'm counting on you.
Okay, great, thank you. It's good to be counted on, I guess.
Hi, everyone in the lab.
Hello.
How's it going? My name is Spectre. I'm the conqueror of the new Earth and the leader of the monkeys of the new age.
Monkeys.
You? M-O- Aren't you the monkey from earlier? What's going on here?
Motna. Ah, that's not a good acronym. Or initialism.
At the amusement park.
What? He's that cute white monkey that everyone loved.
Well, I don't remember. What I can say is that I've acquired distinguished knowledge and great power. I owe it to you, Professor, for inventing the helmet.
Listen well, Spectre. It is true that the peak point helmet you've acquired will exert your dormant knowledge when it's worn. It may even make you a genius. It is still incomplete and is very dangerous to use right now. I advise you to return the peak point helmet right away.
Incomplete? It's a wonderful invention. It's too late now, anyway. We've already made a new peak-point helmet ourselves.
Andrew, oh my gosh, dude.
Product with increased
it's the white part that's cracking me up.
Anyway,
don't know why I did that.
My comrades and monsters,
of course you are. You're one of the nation's favorite white monkeys.
No longer will humans be the dominant species. I'm going to conquer the world. Don't try to stop me.
Don't you dare try to stop me this time, Smee.
What are you talking about?
Spike. Yeah, you banana.
Right, Spike?
Oh, yes.
Right?
Spike. I've prepared a good playmate for you.
Maybe. Oh, no. It's.
Spike. I've been thinking of settling things with you someday.
Oh, my God.
Listen.
Our old friend gone evil.
And there's nothing you can do about it.
Let's see about that.
Why? Why is Buzz there?
How could you, Buzz?
And what's happened? You're totally different. Buzz, pull yourself together.
He'll turn from Buzz.
Can you hear me?
It's no use, Katie. He is being controlled by Spectre.
Oh, nuts.
Right you are, Professor. The Buzz you see here isn't the same old Buzz anymore. He has been reborn! Well, everyone at the lab, I will enjoy...
See, Andrew Monkey would never do this.
Goodbye!
Goodbye. The plot thickens. Six monkeys, my God. We really are getting on in this game. Six monkeys? Six. That's insane. Okay.
Do your best.
Do your best. Looks like the monkeys are hiding somewhere. Oh yeah, bloody radar. Okay. Select gadget. Monkey radar. Nice. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Oh. Ah, the rewind feature. Pretty cool. Don't need it there. Alright, let's find them hidden apes. Bees. Okay. Oh, God! Shit. Okay, they're cranking up the difficulty here for real. Also, why did they call it Apedar? Come on. Come on. Yes. Fucking hell, man. Monkey's kicking my ass. Don't you dare. I saw you go in there. Oh, man. Can't we all just get along? Maybe you should just get in my net! Brilliant. Alright. I think we found our next ape. Aha! The camera's no bueno, shit. The hell, man? Well, apes are actually really vicious, and you know, you should actually avoid them. Unless you're a trained ape, anti-ape escapist, like Spike here. I wonder where the raid. He's got a gun! He's got sunglasses and a gun. Did he choose the thug life or, you know? They've got guns now. I don't know. Right, everybody. We're going to take a quick ad break. We do one every hour. It really helps support the channel, so if you stick around, that would just make you a total awesome person. But I've just prepared something a little bit special for the break. And I do mean a little bit special, so don't, you know, don't hold your breath. But everybody, be back in a minute and a half. Stick around for some more Ape Escape. Thank you very much for watching tonight. And let's do more of it in a second. Okay. This is going to be a bit raw because I just thought of this idea now, but this is going to get better in future streams as I'll prepare it and do it offline. Anyway, see you after the break. I told you it would be smooth. But yeah, you know, there's an idea of what they'll look like in the future for all subscribers who don't see the actual ads. We get to watch the cool older ads. But yeah, they used to be great, didn't they? So great. Now it's all just Bet365 and Gamble 24/7 and Poker 420. That's my favorite. Remember the gaming one when the baby was born? I do, actually. What was that? PlayStation again. PlayStation had some out there ads, didn't they? Which overall just helped to establish their unique brand and help them stand out visually in the marketplace. Of course, there are many demographics that are... No! Okay. Ape Dar. Can I use it underwater? That's the question. No. Yeah, and it did end up in the grave. So cool. PlayStation. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, 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 what? He's in a little spaceship. Can I get in a little spaceship? Typical. There's always all the spaceships for the apes and none for us. Okay. Great start there. Let's kill this guy. So he doesn't watch me fail over and over again. Can I? Is this even possible? Yes! It's possible, the ship is damaged. No. Nice depth perception there. Speaking of which, I think I will do at least one MGS5 stream with an eye patch on. I haven't sourced one yet, though. Yes! Good hit. Come back round, or fall. Oh! He's down! Don't want him getting in another one. Yes, net. Mm-hmm. Satisfying! Fun game. I like it. Anything else around here? No. Well, yeah, there is, but I'm not getting up there. Am I? Let me in a spaceship. That's pretty cool. Right. Let's come about. See what we can do about these Remainers. Or bloody Ramonas, am I right? We just need to get Ape Escape done. And we want a red, white and blue Ape Escape by the end of it. Thank God this professor was so ready for this ape emergency. And he was preparing all these ape gadgets especially. Yeah, I'm guessing I'm gonna be going back in that tunnel. Or maybe not. Can I do anything here? Can I make that jump? Right. Yes! Ah, that's a shame. Ah, nuts. Oh! Any benefit from going up there? Not that I can see. Yes. Yeah, I'd say it could have done with a stronger soundtrack. Like I said, coming from the N64, I would notice that, you know, equivalent games on the PlayStation wouldn't have as strong a presentation overall. Like Croc, I played on my cousin's PlayStation, which was gonna be a Yoshi game. But Nintendo were like, nah, mate. Cool bouncy mushrooms. Oh no, this is too early in the game to get stuck. Did look a bit of a creep, that guy. What's this guy saying? Yeah. Yeah, you should make one for me. Is he talking about coming back later on in the game when I've got a flying gadget? Or can I, in fact, get into one of the spaceships? Because at the moment, now I don't know where to go. Shame they didn't use it for dual analog camera controls. Oh well. Right. No. So there are two exits from the river. That's good news. I think this is the way that I can't go. Though, so. Yep, spaceship place. Does it feel like giving me one now? Darn. Yeah, this way. Surface. I think I've been here before as well, though. No. Very cool. Just to be safe. Okay. Oh man. That guy doesn't look happy, does he? Shit! The controls are really hard. Right. Are you serious, bro? Oh man, they're clearly very excited to use these new analog sticks, but Jesus. Turn the other way. Oh my God. Come on. Yeah. Oh no. Okay, awesome progress we're making here. Oh, now I see why they call them rapids and not slowpids. Oh my God. Why is that making me turn that way? And then I do the same with the other ore and it makes me turn in the same direction? That doesn't make any sense. Oh my God. No! Yes! No. Right, let's... Okay, 360 turns is what you're looking for. Oh, oh my God. Oh my god. There's not even a monkey here. Oh, fuck off. Over all that. I got one of these fancy coins. They just look great. You know, like the cups in Mario Kart. All upscaled gold polygons look great. You are now lost on an island. Oh, don't tell me that. Okay. Another time, old friend. Oh, God. Okay. Oh, my God. Right. No, other way. See why this doctor specializes in ape equipment and not regular nautical equipment. Do I even need to go in that boat? I just swam normally. Right. Yes. Yes! Excellent ape satisfaction when you get one. 8 out of 10. God. Right, yeah, because I'm wondering, like, what? Well, why do I need this boat if it's impossible to row? Okay. No! Oh my. Right, forget those collectibles, I just want to get out of here. Okay. Okay. Yeah. I see, forget the collectibles. What I meant was stylishly collect all of them. Oh no. Oh, that one's so. Yes! Yes! God, it should be called Raft Escape, brackets, you won't. Oh my god. If you find a strange device, use the Stern Club to hit and examine it. Hit it? There's not even anything here. I don't think so. Anyway. What the hell, man? Oh, okay. He means this strange device. Where's that woman from God of War 3? Just need to put her in that wheel there, and that'll be that. Is it telling me to hit this, or is this just a bug? I think I should have time. Wrong button, go! Go! Alright, if I hit the right button, I'm pretty sure I can make that. Come on, I've got 5 hub knobs for crying out loud. There's nothing I can't do. Right. Go! Come on. Ah! Get off of it! Just give me the information! Hit and examine it. Oh. What an app, but why? I mean, it's not thinking I'm getting in the raft and going through there in that time. Me in the raft. The hell is she talking about? Waternet is fast. Is she thinking in the internet? Why is that bit of the fence flashing? Okay, I do think it's doable now. It's annoying, but I think we can do it. My last ape.
Well done.
Oh, please do tell me why it's flashing, Lou Bear, because I've got absolutely no idea. Thank you for chatting, for popping up and letting me know that you've got the knowledge, the ape knowledge. But we got that monkey. Yeah, I just beasted it, mate. In the future, you'll have to come back to this level. You can break it with a new tool instead of doing the whole dive thing. I like it, Lou. Thanks for the info. And in the future, so much of a time element to this game. I thought it would just be apes, but no, they're like, you know, let's spoil them. Let's give them apes and time. And here we are. Excuse me, everybody. Dark Ruins. Let's bring some light to them. It is a really fun game. My first time ever playing it, and it's enjoyable in 2023, which is great to see. And trophies. Isn't it a shame that Nintendo never implemented any sort of trophy achievement system? Because, you know, going back and platinuming Super Mario Bros. 3, for example, would just be so brilliant. It's a shame. Crawling with enemies this place. The hell is that? taking no nonsense. Taking more than one hit. How am I making this? No, damn it. Too late to activate double jump. Come back here, you. Wish I had a sprint. Wish I was a little bit taller. Where'd he go? Yes! Net, quick! Make net profits from that ape. Can I get in there yet? Was there an entrance? I was too busy focused on that guy. One ex-escaped ape. No, not right now. Ow. Oh my god, these guys don't mess around. But what a reward. All the biscuits I could ever eat. We got a little monkey around here? Ah! Go inside the runes, the titular dark runes themselves. It's like Pokemon Guard in this level. Oh no! Multiplying Oh no! Ugh. Just look at me run away from the smallest, pinkest enemies of all time. Wonderful stuff. Aha, I see you! He doesn't see me yet, I like it. Yeah, I did think there'd be more of a stealthy sneaking up on the apes approach, but maybe in the later games, huh? Indiana Jones temple this level. Right, where are we looking at now? Ah, yes, why would I need to crawl at the moment? But yes, I had discovered that. Ah, crawling for stealth. Whoa, how'd I do that? How'd I do that? That's awesome. I know. It's great, isn't it? You can put a lightsaber in your media, just don't call it a lightsaber. Just sneak up on them. That's awesome. I hadn't thought of that at all. Thank you, Lubear. Come on now! Okay, we'll come around. That was nearly tragic. That tool I don't have. Go! Hello. Another one with a weapon. Terrifying. Don't you dare shoot me. Sweet. Halfway there. And what was this handprint thing? Yeah, I guess. Can I just jump straight down there? We're talking full damage? Of course not, what am I? Ready for you. Yeah, I was hoping so. Onwards. Yeah, fun game, fun game. And this is why I'm still interested in Jumping Flash. Check out these... Because, you know... If you're kind of my age, you know, platform gamer at heart, and it's great to catch up on these PlayStation 1 games that I've just never played. Whoa. Aha! Nowhere to run. Oh, but you can still fuck me up. Little ape in a nappy. Oh, is there not a lot of love for 2 or 3? In the Ape Escape series. Ah! What a tease! All that stuff. Oh, I can push it as I am. Okay. Get on the way back. Hmm, that red switch must do something. I will press it. How could you not? Jumping press as well. The best press. Very, very typical PlayStation 1 game music at the time. And that's something I didn't like at the time. A lot of games all of a sudden had kind of like generic dance music, and some of it just sounded like I said, too generic. This isn't one of them. It's got some personality to it, sure, but especially at that age, I'm more about the kind of anthemic video game tunes that Mario 64 was pumping out. Could use the radar, but just a little explorer as well. No apes this way, I should use the radar. Hold on, was there a coin there? Yes. Interesting hitbox on those coins for sure. But like I said, it's really generous when you're swinging the not lightsaber at the not apes. Ha! Hello, buddy. No, don't do that. God damn it. Oh no. I am making progress, just very, very slowly. I'm coming to get you very slowly. If I stop the service, am I just going to get pushed back? Kinda. Can't even go this way anymore. Switch. Yes. Come here, you. Oh no! Oh god! Too late for sneaking now. Bridge. Nice. God. This ape chase is becoming quite epic! No! Damn it. Where's it gonna put me? Where's it gonna respawn me? Oh, come on. I would have got that coin though, I think. I don't know. I have to go back and get that again. What was this? Like one of the boss apes? Dude. Can't do anything about these guys? No, we'll just be running from them, I think. Very cool. Didn't notice this bit before. What's happened? What the hell, dude? Go! Crying out loud. That was the problem. Okay. Nice. Can I still slash him? Oh, yeah! All that Metal Gear training paid off. I knew it would come in handy in another aspect of life. Who said that? Nice. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Is that an extra life? Greed, I just want some gold triangles. Right. Is there just one more waiting for me over here? That would be nice. Shit! Ah, Chris, no problems at all, dude. Thank you once again for choosing this game. Thank you for being an amazing subscriber. Thanks for all the support. Thanks for all the love. And it's been great to hang out with you tonight, man. Take care and I'll see you soon. See you very soon. That sounded threatening. I didn't mean it to be. Go this side and get these ones. Why does he stop like that? Oh no. Right. Right. Go! You know what? I'm just gonna swim it. That's the decision I have come to today. I stand by it. Oh my word. It seems quite hard, doesn't it? Nice and early on the double jumps. Yeah. Okay, when can I start the sneak? Here again, you little son of a bitch. This worked out nicely. I thought he was over here. On the side of the door, I guess. Ha ha! Don't stand there.
Well done.
Oh yes, thank you very much. Well, you know, that is one pretty cool game about catching apes.
You're good.
Cheers. I got good at this game. But what other games are coming up on this channel? That's a segue. Are coming up on this channel. Like I said, Monday Gear Solid is back tomorrow with Metal Gear Solid 5 The Phantom Pain continued. Yakuza Day debuts on Tuesday. First dive into the Yakuza series for me, probably. I've done a little bit here and there. And the rest of the week stream will be up in the air because of minor surgery. But I'll be back very soon after Tuesday, but I just don't know when that'll be right now. But we are going to leave the stream there for tonight, everybody. I hope you had a good time checking out Ape Escape with me. I thought that was fun. Yeah, I did. Thanks again to Chris for picking it. Thanks again for all of you guys for being here. And yeah, and that really is the end of the stream. So enjoy the rest of your Sunday, everybody. Don't forget the Joker. Remember, the final event is the Eliminator. I've been Psycho Fox, comma the. You've been the best. Take care and goodbye. See ya.